No. Oh my God!
Sorry. You're not invited. This is a broom closet down there.
I'll take care of him, and I'll take care of this.
Hold on a minute. Listen to me, please, Solo. Winning and losing matters here. There are consequences to losing. We lost. That's the champ's locker room, and Cody Rhodes is the champion. If we want our locker room back, the title has to come home to the Bloodline. And that's by order of the tribal chief.
So there's consequences to losing, right? Right?
Right.
So that means consequences need change.
Process what we saw earlier here tonight on SmackDown, that being Jimmy Uso taken out by his own brother Solo Sikoa and newcomer Tama Tonga. And I'm currently standing outside the trainer's room where I saw Paul Heyman enter moments ago to check on Jimmy Uso. Hopefully we're going to get an update on his condition. Paul, first and foremost, is Jimmy okay? What happened out there?
By orders of the tribal chief.
Hey,
the hell does that mean? Solo? Nice threads.
Wise man, meet the newest member of the Bloodline. My MFT.
Solo. I say
is this Kevin
to you.
Owens here? Is Kevin Owens here?
I presume he is. If he is, he's most likely inside the locker room. The show's already started.
Then take me to him.
Okay. It's this way. Listen, I'm sorry that we can't find Kevin Owens, but he has to be here. Look at the time. Solo, we're gonna find him. I mean, he has to be somewhere in this locker room. Look at Solo. Solo. I'm not trying to piss you off. Please believe me, the last person on this planet I want to piss off is you. But respectfully, Solo, you're making decisions that are not yours to be made yet. One day, these will all be your exclusive decisions, but not now, not here. These are decisions that can only be made by one man.
Are you done yet? Are you?
Last week, I had to lose a brother. I had to. In order for me to find a new one, my MFT, Tama Tonga.
Tonga.
Kevin Owens needs medical attention.
Remaining Pittsburgh PD to protect him from Tama Tonga. This man is absolutely ruthless, the son of Haku, who is renowned as the toughest man to ever step foot in this industry. Kevin Owens.
Kevin, no.
Defiant in his current state. Someone needs to protect Kevin Owens from himself. My God, taking the fight to Tama Tonga.
Kevin Owens just doesn't know when he's a beaten man.
Kevin Owens tonight about to go from bad to even worse at the hands of the Bloodline. No, double leg Tama.
We know Kevin Owens, if there's oxygen in the body, he's going to keep on swinging very much to his
Samoan
detriment.
Spike! Upon arrival tonight, Solo asked about the whereabouts of Kevin Owens. And now, Tama Tonga, Solo's MFT, has just been unleashed.
This guy is just reckless.
Get some more help out here. This guy is a savage.
Is he not dumb?
Who's gonna stop him?
Not me, that's for sure.
We saw this happen last week with the assistance of a steel chair taking out Jimmy Uso. Thank God for all this. falling off his MFT, Tama Tonga.
What have we learned in 2 weeks? Where Tama Tonga goes, carnage swiftly follows.
I want you to come with me. I want to show you something. Were you aware of this?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Are you meaning to tell me you didn't know about this, Paul? All right, let me paint you a picture. One of those rental cars belongs to Kevin Owens, and the other one is your boy Tama Tonga's. Now, Paul.
This was not authorized.
I understand.
This was not.
No, I'm speaking now. I understand conflict between authorized. The boys. But on my show, we settle it in the ring. Now, next week, we've got the draft. Yeah? A lot of eyeballs. Top brass. Tippy top brass. You understand? So I will not tolerate this kind of savage behavior.
I don't blame you.
Just tell me you understand.
I understand.
Now make sure the bloodline understands. Because, Paul, if you don't, the repercussions are going to be equally savage. Losing isn't the only thing that has consequences.
I'm sorry. I know I always get the door for Roman. I understand. I'll get the door for you from now on.
Wise man.
Yes.
So the bloodline got drafted, right?
Well, not exactly. Not yet.
Give me all the details.
Okay. Roman Reigns withdrew from the draft right before the show began. And with all due respect, you're adding new members now, which means nobody knows what they're getting in a draft when they draft the bloodline. Oh, God. Easy. Please.
Wise man.
So,
I need you to repeat that for me one more time.
No!
From tomorrow, streaming live, WWE on Peacock. Look at the background. That's Kevin Owens. And that's the MFT. Owens bringing the fight to Tama Tonga. Looking to take back his pound of flesh.
Well, KO can be a beaten man, but the truth is he never stays beaten for long. And Tama Tonga is about to learn that firsthand.
Double leg by Owens. But here comes Solo. And the numbers, yet again, overwhelming Kevin Owens.
KO has learned nothing from his experience last week. But he's going to keep on swinging with all his might.
And look at the MFT just wrecking everyone in his path.
Every single security guard getting dropped. These guys aren't paid enough.
I think security certainly deserves hazard pay when you're dealing with the bloodline. Poor Hurricane nearly got flattened.
Jamie Noble desperately trying to drag KO. Oh.
Talk about an unexpected ally.
Of all the music in the world you do not want to hit, it's Randy Orton.
Tama and Solo trying to bull rush the Viper. Solo escaping the RKO. Orton giving chase.
face is a complete meltdown.
Anybody expected to see Randy Orton tonight? Certainly not bringing the fight to the Bloodline. I know Owens would have never asked for help, but KO's got to be happy to see Orton.
This would have ended up gruesome had Randy Orton not shown up in the nick of time, and we might get back to it.
Owens isn't done yet. Kevin Owens will not rest. Kevin Owens will not settle. KO may not sleep until this issue is resolved.
This is certainly not the last we've seen from these four.
Did you get my memo?
I did. Request denied. You want me to pull Kevin Owens and Randy Orton out of the tag team match tomorrow night at Backlash? Why? Why would I do that?
I don't know. For the sake of Kevin Owens? For the sake of Randy Orton? For the sake of the SmackDown? You know what? I've tried and tried and tried with you. Leave them in the damn match as far as I'm concerned, okay? What happens to Randy Orton and Kevin Owens tomorrow night is no longer on my conscience, Mr. Aldis. What happens to Kevin Owens and Randy Orton tomorrow night is on your conscience. Good night.
Is that by orders of the tribal chief?
That's not funny. That's not funny.
Well, just all communication to the Bloodline of Roman Reigns must go through Paul Heyman. Are you in charge?
You know, there's a difference between being in charge and being in control. I haven't even spoken to Roman Reigns since WrestleMania.
I'm sorry. What did you just say? You haven't spoken to Roman Reigns since WrestleMania? So when Roman Reigns pulled himself out of the WWE draft...
Roman Reigns did not pull himself out of the WWE draft. I pulled Roman Reigns out of the WWE draft. You have to understand what's going on here. I had no choice. I cannot subject Roman Reigns to the chaos that's going on within the Bloodline right now. And you can't subject Kevin Owens and Randy Orton to what awaits them at the hands of the Bloodline tomorrow night.
Well, you know what, Paul? If you can take it on yourself to pull Roman Reigns out of the draft, then why don't you try pulling Randy and Kevin out of that match at Backlash? You can try right now on the RKO show. It's up next. Bon courage, Mr. Heyman.
Who exactly is the real tribal chief?
Oh, you put me in a bad position. I think the whole world knows there's only one tribal chief.
But look out! Solo and Tama Tonga from behind. This is a preview for what's going to go down tomorrow at Backlash. It's going to be ugly. It's going to be brutal. These four are trying to destroy each other.
Simply cannot be in the same vicinity without trying to rip each other apart.
Randy Orton standing toe-to-toe with the enforcer, Solo Sikoa.
Got some reinforcements out here desperately trying to tear these four away from one another.
You might want to call in the French National Guard. This is crazy. You're going to need more than a couple. There we go.
Finally, the reinforcement.
Oh, well, look out! Orton! Laying waste to the security staff. The Viper has lost it. Owens taking out everyone. and standing the high ground.
This incarnation of the Bloodline is ruthless, but KO and Orton are ready to match that intensity.
Tom, I know you're new around here, but this is never good to try.
He hooked him! He hooked him!
Heyman is as shocked as anyone in this arena.
And out of steps on Orton. And out of Kevin Owens as well.
So look, can I just have one moment of your time alone, please? Thank you. Listen, I know my place in life. I'm Roman's wise man. But Solo, you're making decisions.
Like the decision to lie and pull Roman from the draft? Yeah. That one backfired on us, Paul. Because of that mistake, we got drafted in the third round when we should have been number one. It's like you're trying to take money out of my pocket. You trying to do that?
No.
Huh? You trying to take food away from my kids to eat? Huh? You want my kids to starve, Paul?
No.
Or last week, you walked by my brother Jay. Did you try to, like, give him a signal or a look that you needed help?
No.
Okay. I understand you're the wise man. I know you're trying to protect Roman from the draft, protect us, protect the family, the Bloodline. Okay. And you haven't spoken to Roman since he lost our title at WrestleMania, right?
Right.
Well, I have. I've spoken to him.
What?
And until he comes back, I'm in charge of the Bloodline. I call the shots. And you will be my wise man. By orders of the tribal chief. Now give me a hug, wise man. Bring it in. It's okay. Bring it in. Yeah. I love you. I love you, wise man.
Here comes Tama Tonga. Dawkins out of the way just in time. Again, Angelo Dawkins competing on behalf of the almighty Bobby Lashley, who went down with an injury during training for this matchup. And Dawkins might turn the whole tournament upside down.
And this is a tough spot for Dawkins, who at short notice has had to get ready for a singles match. Remember, of course, he is a tag team specialist historically. Very different wheelhouse tonight, but he might pull off a shocker here, much to the dismay of Solo Sikoa.
Solo Sikoa, who we learned moments ago, is, oh my God,
jeez,
running the Bloodline in the absence of Roman Reigns. Dawkins just pounced. Oh, Dawkins not about to hear it.
This is an Angelo Dawkins.
Taking out the Bloodline, making it look easy. Sky high to Tama Tonga. Dawkins gonna do it. Punk is taking his eye off the ball. I can tell you right now it's gonna cost him. Face first goes AD, hook of the leg by Tama Tonga. And Tama Tonga gonna advance.
Here is your winner, Tama Tonga.
They are as deep as they are dangerous.
Just ruthlessly efficient.
That's a cross body by Knight. Tama Tonga out of sorts for the first time in this matchup.
Bloodline Knight needs to try and finish this as quickly as possible, but with Tama Tonga on the outside, that seems unlikely.
And the LA Knight doing the right thing here by continuing to pour on the punishment, deliver an onslaught of offense for this maniacal Tonga.
With every shot that LA Knight gives to Tama Tonga, understandably, he has to stare over at the Bloodline to make sure they're not encroaching.
And you can see Tonga Loa wincing every time Tama Tonga's head made impact with the ring apron. The brother of Tama Tonga eager to inflict some punishment of his own on LA Knight.
Tonga Loa is the muscle of this new format of the Bloodline.
Uh-oh, pop-up power slam!
Very little he can do to help right now.
LA Knight picking up the pieces, putting them back together, and Knight could be on the precipice of a win. The MFT Tama Tonga down in the center of the ring. LA Knight lining it up. Could we be in for a BFT?
Wounds of war all over the body of LA Knight. Finish this quick, megastar.
Tonga Loa coming to the aid of his brother. Look out! Knight drop kicking Tonga Loa into the announce desk.
Get your ass up!
Come on up and do it.
Back it up, Solo!
Come on up and do it. Right there.
Tell you to back it up.
Bad blood between Solo Sikoa and the megastar LA Knight, but keep your eyes on Tama Tonga, who may have just ended this. LA Knight down. Tonga hooks the leg. Tama Tonga is going to the next round.
Here is your winner, Tama Tonga.
Gunther will face the winner of this one as Tama Tonga bulldozes Randy into the ropes.
Gunther's opponent tomorrow is getting battered, whomever it may be at the end of this match.
Wait a second. Tonga may have just put himself in harm's way. Vintage Orton.
It's the point in the match you just stop thinking clearly. You go on instincts and put yourself in danger. And there aren't many places in that ring that are safe when you're in there with the fight.
Man, you can feel that. The Jeddah Superdome is rumbling right now. Because the Viper is coiled. Orton stalking a fallen Tama Tonga. Big right hand for Solo. Tama Tonga from behind. Shoulders down. Tonga's gonna steal it. No.
Almost enough with the destroyer. There is
RKO!
Your winner, Randy Orton!
And the Apex Predator takes one more giant step toward the throne. Look out, Solo from behind. Just flattened Randy Orton.
Fighter.
Kevin Owens coming to the aid of his friend Randy Orton and maybe saving the Viper from certain disaster.
We haven't seen KO in weeks after his beatdown by the Bloodline, a Backlash.
When Randy needed him most, Kevin Owens answered the call.
Solo has no respect for you. And he is recruiting these criminals into the Bloodline. We, Roman Reigns and I, turned down every new member of the Bloodline because we did background checks on them. We didn't want these people in the Bloodline representing the Bloodline. These are the people that you're picking a fight with, Kevin. These are the people that you're antagonizing. These are the people that, they're not even people. They're just bloodthirsty, sadistic thugs. They're not looking for a reason to take you out. They're looking for any excuse to take you out. And that's bad for WWE. I like you in WWE. They love you in WWE. And if you keep on calling out Solo's name, they're going to do something really bad about it. I am asking you, I'm pleading with you, Kevin Owens, I'm begging you, back off the Bloodline, please.
I'm not falling for it. And I have that figured out, but I don't know what this little act is about. What are you trying to do? You're trying to make sure everybody fears them? You're trying to instill fear? Guess what? I fought the Bloodline for 4 years, and they gave me everything they had. They threw me off of high things. They handcuffed me to those ropes, super kicked me 20 times. They hit me with a golf cart, and I am still standing right here, and I had a great time. But that was the Bloodline. That was Roman Reigns and Jay and Jimmy Uso. Guys that I too respect. That Solo and the two guys, that's not the Bloodline. That's just Solo and two guys I don't want to know, I don't care to know, and nobody wants here. So you think for a second that I'm gonna stop fighting them? Hell no, I will keep fighting them. In fact, I will do everything I can to get them the hell out of my world, and this is my world. And as far as your help goes, I don't want it, and I don't need it.
Great power from Dawkins, Ford making the climb. Blockbuster! Cover by Dawkins! And Tama Tonga keeps this one alive for the Bloodline.
That must be the first time I've seen a grimace of pain on the face of Tonga Loa.
Not a frequent occurrence, that's for damn sure. And Loa just flattened Dawkins again.
Wobbled but shaking off the cobwebs is Tonga Loa cooking up something else devious.
Well, allegedly, Tonga Loa is the more even keeled of the brothers, but
oh God! Wait.
Man, that's a pretty low bar.
I'm not sure. I think Tama Tonga tagged Tonga Loa. Dawkins has no idea.
I don't think Tonga Loa knew anything about it either.
Montez Ford making the climb. Tonga Loa is down in the center of the ring from the heavens. But here comes Tama. Face first goes Ford, hooks the leg. And the Bloodline with the W.
Here are your winners, T-Mob, Tonga Loa, and Tama Tonga.
Solo sits at the head of the table. From that position that tonight Solo has once again upped the ante in the name of family honor and declared this a double proclamation. I call to your collective attention this man to my right, already anointed by Solo, a fully fledged member of the Bloodline. But from this moment forward, he will no longer be known only as Tama Tonga. From this moment forward, he will be known as Tama Tonga, the right-hand man. I also call your attention to the man on my left. Ladies and gentlemen, history in front of your very eyes right now. Because from this moment on, the story of the Bloodline will never be complete if you don't include the fact that a fully fledged member of the Bloodline stands before you right now in the form of the infamous Tonga Loa.
Samo and Spike incoming. Stunner! Cover by Owens. And ripped out of the ring by Tama Tonga, Tonga Loa.
Complete genius move by these two Tongans.
Oh, but Dawkins now joining the fray.
Just as we suspected, things breaking down in the worst way.
Yeah, much to the surprise of absolutely no one. What go! Montez Ford from the skies. And Solo in a steel chair. That's going to force a disqualification. But good God, man. Dawkins muscling Solo back inside the squared circle.
Yeah, the bell's already rung. This one's over. We don't need rules anymore, Corey.
The infamous Tonga Loa letting his force be felt by Angelo Dawkins.
Try and protect your bodies. You try and protect KO. Try and protect Montez Ford. This is what you earn. Be warned, SmackDown locker room.
Try as you might to protect your own buddies. You are dealing with the Bloodline. You are dealing with a family of warriors, Wade. How in the hell do you stop the Bloodline?
Simple answer, you don't, Corey. You just have to avoid.
Oh, a spear by Solo.
KO ain't done, that's for sure. If there is breath in the lungs of KO, he's gonna keep swinging.
That may be to Kevin Owens' own detriment tonight when you're dealing with Solo. And the MFTs, the Tongans, the infamous Tonga Loa, the right-hand man, Tama Tonga. Hey, Wade, I think we need to get the hell out of the way. Oh, God. Oh, God. This is going to be the end of Kevin Owens.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Kevin Owens through the table at the hands of Solo and the Bloodline. And KO kicks out.
Disbelief in the eyes of Solo Sikoa, who is perhaps aware there really is very little left in his arsenal to put the prize fighter away.
Here comes Solo, super kick. The second puts down Sikoa.
I have to think KO's body, KO's brain is not working at the moment. This is all instinctive, and it might do the job.
Knees up. On attempt, but the knees were up. I don't think Owens is using his brain right now, Wade. This is all heart. Samo and Spike, Owens avoids it. Stunner! And Heyman just saved his own rear end.
Solo Sikoa was a beaten man. Paul Heyman was a dead man, except for that intervention.
Owens has had about enough. Don't do it, KO. Oh, no, 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 no. No, 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 no.
Samoan spike to a distracted KO.
This is going to do it if Solo connects. Samoan spike. You can count to 30.
Here is your winner, Solo Sikoa!
Oh, shoot.
Whoa.
Turn around, Cody. You got company.
The Bloodline's Solo Sikoa.
From behind, the rest of the Bloodline. Tama Tonga, Tonga Loa.
After a man who has just put himself through hell.
But what did Solo Sikoa say on SmackDown? That he was going to take care of the Cody Rhodes problem. And now the Bloodline with a problem of their own.
Rhodes has backup. It's Owens and Orton. Last night on SmackDown, Randy Orton returned to aid the prize fighter, and this score is far from settled.
I don't know how the hell Cody is still up and swinging.
Well, survival. They're trying to survive.
And for once, the Bloodline doesn't have a numbers advantage.
This has turned into a six-man brawl.
So the favor that I'm doing for you is to say to you with love and respect that against your own instincts, please get the hell out of here right now.
You want me to leave? Because Solo and the Tongans are gonna try to jump me in Chicago?
More security than it's already here, Wade.
Nobody can make enemies like CM Punk.
Hey, yo, Punk, if you want to be on SmackDown, on my show, yeah, in my city, you got two options. Two. One, you pay your respect to me and the Bloodline, or two, we about to make sure your ass never, ever gets cleared to wrestle again.
What's the favor you wanted to ask of me if I do you this favor?
Take me with you?
I acknowledge The fact that I don't see the Bloodline standing in front of me, I see a bunch of fake-ass Usos. And a phony cosplay tribal chief.
Oh, it's about to pop off. CM Punk standing his ground, ill-advised as it may be.
This is a fight you cannot win, Punk, even here in Chicago.
Oh, no, this does not look good. Wait a minute! It's the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes!
Armed with a couple of equalizers.
I did your bidding. I told the Tongans. They took care of business just like you wanted. Solo, you're breaking commandments. Before Roman got on his jet after WrestleMania, there were several things that he said to me. He agreed that CM Punk was hands off. That's CM Punk is very personal to me. And Cody Rhodes is not something that you're supposed to handle. All you're supposed to do is have Cody Rhodes in check so that when the tribal chief Roman Reigns comes back.
Wise man. Let me stop you right there. I hate to be the one to tell you this. Because I love you. But Roman, he's not coming back.
I think reality is beginning to set in for the new head of the table. Solo's pleading.
I've never seen Solo Sikoa back and plead for his safety before. Is that this?
Oh my God, Wade!
Who is it?
The rumors are true! Oh. You know who that is?
Oh my God.
That's Jacob Fatu.
He's here.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Solo, what the hell have you done?
Oh my God. Jacob Fatu. That's Samoan drop Owens onto the stairs. We thought Tama Tonga and Tonga Loa were dangerous, Wayne. This guy needs to be locked up.
This is the family member the same ones want nothing to do with.
Oh my, he just put Orton into the barricade. Yeah. This SOB ain't fit for public consumption. Watch it, I'm telling you, Wade.
You don't have to tell me twice, Corey.
Yeah! Cody! Standing his ground, the WWE champion continuing to fight.
Well, he has to. He's in a fight for his life now. It's Jacob Fatu.
Spine first onto the ring apron.
This guy is as lawless as can be.
Solo, what have you done? What sort of hell has been unleashed on Friday Night SmackDown by Solo and the Bloodline?
Well, this completely redefines risk-reward. The risk with Jacob Fatu is sky high. But what we're seeing now is pure reward for the Bloodline.
Oh, my God. Jacob Fatu is going to destroy the WWE Champion on his first night. No. No! Oh my God! God help us all! There's a werewolf on the loose!
What is the best one? Wise man, look at me when I'm talking to you. Acknowledge me as your tribal chief.
I love you.
I love you too.
And I acknowledge that you are not my tribe.
Oh my God! Samoan spike to the wise man!
The biggest mistake of Heyman's life, and it might be his last.
That's right! You understand me? I love you! I tried to! Get out of here! Get out of here!
What in the hell is happening? What are these maniacs gonna do to the Hall of Famer? For the love of God, don't do this to the man! Refused to kiss the ring, and he's going to be led to the gallows. Wade, get the hell out of here. It's not safe for us to be here. These maniacs are going to wreck everything.
Oh, my God, no.
Don't do this. No, 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 no. Out here. Get him some help!
Olafala. This makes me the tribal chief. This is not what I wanted, but this is what my family needed. Roman Reigns was not man enough to defend our title at WrestleMania. He was not man enough to defend our legacy against Cody Rhodes and his legacy. Therefore, he shall no longer call himself the Tribal Chief, because I'm the Tribal Chief now. And I am going to take back our WWE Undisputed title from Cody Rhodes. And if Roman Reigns wants that back, he can try and take it from me. Because I am going to show everyone in the Money in the Bank six-man tag match, Cody Rhodes, I am coming for you. And you will acknowledge me.
Championship at WrestleMania.
with what would be three crossroads, and from behind,
oh, no, he's
Jacob
back.
Fatu, top rope, wipes out Cody.
That's what we're talking about, that freakish athleticism.
Well, can we get another official out here before all these guys just destroy each other?
Implant DDT. And I don't think the nightmare is going to wake up.
And now, Jacob Fatu lifting the tribal chief, Solo Sikoa, to his feet. Cody Rhodes is defenseless. Solo Sikoa. With the death blow. The Samoan spike. You can count to tomorrow. The official tossed back in the ring by Fatu to count the one, two, and three. The Bloodline dominance.